Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to continue finding the sum of an infinite geometric series, and we're going to do this with a repeating decimal. Here we see the formula where S is the sum, and then here I have a sub 1, which is going to be the first term or the first number that you have to work with the repeating decimal, and then 1 minus R, where R is what's known as the common ratio, and that's the value that you're multiplying each term by. All right, that common ratio should be between negative 1 and positive 1. So basically, a positive or negative fraction that's less than 1. All right, let's say that the ratio that we're working with this time, let's say it's 0 and 35 repeating. Again, if I were to try to write this out, we would see a series of 35s repeating, and again that goes off into infinity. And if I were to break this up into a series of terms where I had to sum them or add them together, it would look something like this, where the first term would be 35 hundredths, the next term would be 35 ten thousandths, and of course I could continue as such. Alright, and if I were to add these up, and again if I were to continue, this would come out to be that repeating decimal where the 35 is repeating. Right, what we're going to do here is this first term here, a sub 1, is going to be the 35 over 100. And then a sub 2 is going to be 35 over 10,000. All right, so let's start up here with our formula. Well, the first term is 35 over 100. And I need to divide that by the difference of 1 minus R. Well, to figure out R, R is a sub 2 divided by a sub 1. So in this case, a sub 2 is 35 over 10,000 divided by a sub 1, which is 35 over 100. It's a complex fraction, which means I have to multiply by the reciprocal. So I take the denominator and I flip it. So here I have 100 over 35. And again, before I multiply these large numbers out, I can find common factors. 35 divided by 35 is 1. So I do that here and down here. And here I see if I strike off these two zeros here, which means I'm dividing by 100, I can strike two zeros there, which also means I've divided by 100. When I multiply these numerators, I get 1 times 1 to give me 1. And when I multiply my denominator, I end up with 1 times 100. So I see that R is 1 100th, and again 1 100th is between negative 1 and positive 1. So I put this in place, 1 over 100. Again, I rewrite the numerator, 35 over 100. This 1 turns into 100 over 100 minus 1 over 100. Because again, when my numerator and denominator are the same, it resolves down to 1. So now I have a complex fraction. So 35 over 100 divided by, well, 100 minus 1 is 99 over 100. And again, I have to multiply by the reciprocal in this complex fraction. So 35 over 100 times 100 over 99. These hundreds cancel out. 100 divided by 100 is 1. And then I end up with 35 over 99. And I can't do any more simplification there. All right, what I want to do next is pull up the calculator and prove that 35 divided by 99 gives me this decimal of 0.35 repeating. So with the calculator, we're going to put in, alpha y equals, clear that out. Alpha y equals, I want number 1 to get my fraction template. My numerator is 35. My denominator is 99. Press enter, and I see I've got to use the math function. So math and then 2 for decimal. Press enter, and you see here I have the 35 repeating. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spell Up Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you guys for watching.